Hello guys, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. In the previous video, we talked about how to perform grouping in ASP.NET called Blazor. Now this time around, after grouping, let's talk about filtering. How do you filter? If I want to set a particular ID here, a particular row with the ID, first name, last name, or email, is it possible? Yes, it is. So let's get straight ahead. Now let's see how I'm going to apply that in the SF grid. So in a project, the only thing that you need to do here is allow filtering, reset to true. So let's do that. So allow filtering, so let's set this to true. So whilst you're done with this, when you set the filter to true, let's save this. Let's refresh our page and now let's see. So as our page loaded, so we see that we have automatically test boxes that has been created here. Now each of the column has its own test box, and that's known as a search test box. So if I want to search this, let's say ID of 6, passing 6. When you're done, hit on the enter key because you have the ID 6. So if you clear it, you have all. Now if you're looking for rows, just type in rows, enter, you have rows here now. And okay, so if you're looking for MAFO, type enter, you have the MAFO here. Okay, the same thing applies to this side. So if you're looking for this, let's copy this. Let's clear this. Now let's paste this here, enter, and you have the exact information. But you know what? What you want to do here is, as soon as we start typing, we want the search to be done. Watch here. If I pass in 5, nothing happens unless I hit on the enter key. Okay, so let's make it as a key change. So as soon as I start typing, it must search the data and I get the specific row that we are actually talking about. So instead, as soon as I press on 4, 4 should have been popped up. So let's work on that. To actually do that, we have to allow some settings in there. And that's why we have to apply the grid filtering or grid filter settings. We set the mode to what? Immediate. So let's copy this. And now in application, let's go in there. And now on top here, let's apply this. So grid filter settings, we set the mode to immediate. Defaultly, the mode is set to, let's see, the mode is set to on enter. So we set the mode to immediate to make it work. Okay, so this is going to be an immediate. As soon as we start typing, it's going to work. But there's one problem here. Now it delays. When you type, it delays. So let's increase the time that it takes to make a set. So to increase that, the next thing to do here, immediate delay mode, we set it to 200 milliseconds. So let's copy this. And now on here, we can set the immediate mode delay to 200. So this 200 is talking about milliseconds. So let's save this. Now let's refresh application. So our page is now loaded. Now let's see. As soon as I type in 4, let's see what happens because I have 4. Now I clear it, I get all. Now as soon as I pass in R, I have rows. I clear it, I have all. As soon as I type in AR, I have armor. I clear this, I have all this. And you can see it is working. Okay. Alright, so you can see that with the help of the Sync Fusion Data Grid System component, searching, filtering, grouping, and that is a paging, have become so easy for us to implement it. So that is it for this video. I hope this is clear and it's very simple. Just have to allow or apply only few attributes and you're good to go. Apply allow filter settings to true. Now set the filtering settings. They're most supposed to be immediate if you want to search on that. If not, on key enter, as soon as you press on the enter key, it gets searched. Now the delay mode is 200 milliseconds. You can decide to set it to maybe 100 milliseconds or etc. Okay, so that is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this is clear. And we break for now. We meet later to discuss on one important thing as well.